Further on, in this video, we have how, by a rectangle, one semicircle, these are given as tangent gradient. This length is given 10. And the question is, what is the area of the rectangle? Okay. First step, if we connect these two points, notice that there's a diameter opposite of the angle GFC, right? So angle GFC must be equal 90 degrees. After that, let's call here alpha, here theta. So alpha plus theta equal 90 degrees, right? That means angle alpha left here. Okay. After that, if you draw a perpendicular opposite side of the angle alpha like this, here must be equal theta, right? Okay. Then I want to represent this length with R. If you draw one more perpendicular line like this, let's call here point O. O is the center of the semicircle, right? So this length is also R unit. If you notice that the length of the OC and the length of the GO is also R unit, right? Okay. After that, if you focus on triangle GFC, for this triangle, if you calculate sine alpha equal 10 over 2r, right? Okay. Then, if you focus on this triangle, for this triangle, sine alpha equal, let's call here x, so sine alpha equal x over r, right? Therefore, if we equalize these two expressions, 10 over 2r must be equal x over r. Let's simplify. That means x equal 5 units, right? Let's write here x equal 5. Next step. If we connect point F and point D like this, if you notice that the area of this triangle is equal to half of the area of the rectangle, right? Therefore, the area of the ABCD is equal to 2 times the area of the triangle CFD. So rectangle area equal 2 times 5 times 10 over 2. So the area of the rectangle equal 50 units squared. Okay. This was the first method. Now we will calculate value of the area using second method. First of all, let's call here R. So diameter of the semicircle equal to R, right? Okay. Then, if we connect these two points, here is 90 degrees, and let's call here alpha. If you focus on triangle FGC, for this triangle, if you calculate cosine alpha, notice that cosine alpha equal 10 over 2R, right? Now, also, if you focus on this triangle, for this triangle, if you calculate cosine alpha, let's call here M. For this triangle, cosine alpha equal M over 10. Right? Okay. Therefore, if you equalize these two expressions, 10 over 2R must be equal M over 10. That means m times r equal 50, right? Notice that the area of the rectangle ABCD is equal to m times r. That means the area equal 50 units squared. Now let's calculate the area of the rectangle using third method. Let's call here r again, and here let's call a. That means here must be equal 2r minus a, right? Okay. Then if we connect these two points, this length I want to represent with b, then if you focus on triangle FGC, for this triangle, if we apply Euclid theorem, b squared equal a times 2r minus a, right? So b squared equal 2ar minus a squared, right? Now also, if you focus on triangle FBC, for this triangle, if you apply Pythagorean theorem, we get b squared plus 2r minus a whole squared equal 10 squared, right? Therefore, b squared plus 4r squared minus 4a times r plus a squared equal 100, right? If you plug in this value to the equation instead of b squared, 2ar minus a squared. So if you simplify the expression, notice that these are again. So for r squared minus 2ar equal 100, right? Therefore, if you divide both sides of the equation with 2, we get 2r squared minus ar equal 50. Right. Now let's calculate the area of the rectangle. The area of the rectangle ABCD equal 2r minus a times r, right? So 2r squared minus ar. Notice that these two expressions are equal. It means the area of the rectangle is going to be 50 units squared. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and